I'm J.R. Church. Welcome to today's webcast. It's Wednesday, March 31, and it seems that March will be gone in just a few hours, and we'll end up with tomorrow, April Fool's Day. Well, anyway, here's a letter, really nifty letter. I like this. Hi, J.R. Hebrews 10:24-25 says, as we see the day approaching. And Daniel 9:25 says, know therefore and understand it from the going forth of the command to restore and build Jerusalem unto the Messiah, the Prince, shall be 7 weeks. So I want to share these with you as he shared them with me. Psalm 111 begins with hallelujah, first verse. Psalm 112 begins with hallelujah, first verse. Psalm 113 begins with hallelujah, first verse. But then Psalm 114 has no hallelujah. And he suggests that's the possibility of the year of the abomination of desolation. Now, if we get to Psalm 115, we have a hallelujah in the last verse. Psalm 116, we have a hallelujah in the last verse. In Psalm 117, we have a hallelujah in the last verse. And then Psalm 118 is messianic. And Psalm 119, of course, is the Alpha and Omega, the olive to the Tav. It's obviously a messianic psalm. So what we've got here in Psalms 111, 112, and 113 is a menorah design with the servant lamp in the middle, okay, in Psalm 114. So we have these three in the first verse, and these three, that is Psalm 115, 16, and 17, in the last verse. So it's a mirrored image. You see that? It's a mirrored image, just like we have taught in other menorahs of the Bible. It's absolutely fascinating. Thanks for sending it to me. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we'd be out of here this year? I'm not sure that the tribulation period will begin next year, but I know that it is coming. And frankly, I welcome it because that means that Jesus is coming back that much quicker to save the world and set up the Messianic kingdom. Here is a chilling email. In 1952, President Truman established one day a year as National Day of Prayer. In 1988, President Reagan designated the first Thursday in May of each year as the National Day of Prayer. In June of 2007, then presidential candidate Barack Obama declared that the United States was no longer a Christian nation. This year, President Obama canceled the 21st annual National Day of Prayer ceremony at the White House under the ruse of, quote, not wanting to offend anyone. Okay? So after 20 years, at the upcoming 21st annual prayer, National Day of Prayer, Obama canceled it, saying we don't want to offend anybody. But on September 25th, 2009, from 4 a.m. until 7 p.m., a National Day of Prayer for the Muslim religion was held on Capitol Hill beside the White House, and there were over 50,000 Muslims that day in Washington, D.C. And this report says, I guess it doesn't matter if Christians are offended by this event, and we obviously don't count as anyone anymore. And here's the picture of our president taking his shoes off to pray with the Muslims, but he cancels. After 20 years of continual National Day of Prayer, he cancels the 21st annual National Day of Prayer coming up the first Thursday of May. Sad. I want you just to know, okay, that I'm a Bible theologian. I don't own a gun. I never plan to own a gun. I don't plan to do any military. I just want you to know that you don't stick your finger in God's eye and get away with it. By the way, you remember that all that flooding along the East Coast that's been going on for the last several days? Go back 2 weeks ago. You remember the storm without a name? And now this one? God is mad. God is angry with Washington, D.C., and those cities all the way from Washington to Boston are feeling the brunt of God's judgment. I'm confident of it. I've no doubt that this is a God thing. Did you see the swirl on the Weather Channel last night. I mean, it's just amazing how that there's hurricane-type weather going on. And just so, sort of staying there and staying there and staying there. And it may move away today, I don't know. But I tell you what, God's made his point. We need a National Day of Prayer. Whether or not the president observes it, you, my friend, need to be praying. You need to be praying on May the 1st, whether it's in Washington or at your place, at your house. You need to be praying for God to forgive us. We need to be repenting as a nation. And pray for our president that he'll repent. I'm J.R. Church. We'll see you again tomorrow with our analysis of the news.